Chief of Staff John Kelly's electronics ban goes even further than anticipated, as West Wing staffers will be barred from bringing any portable device that emits an electric signal to work. ABC News received a copy of an internal memo sent to staff from Kelly on Wednesday, which indicated that personal cell phones would be banned come January 16, but also laptops, smart watches, like the Apple Watch or Fitbit, and devices with Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, radio or cellular capabilities. All employees' electronics equipment must be issued by the White House Communications Agency, or else, the memo warned. Plus 5 in guide.d.equals i 2087a83a2b0b26ca tesrc equals https rc equals http colon slash i dot daily mail dot co dot uk slash i slash pics slash 2018 slash 01 slash 10 slash 23 slash 47 ffd 960000575254255 image a 16 underscore 15165254255 image 16 underscore 15165260 dot jpg height equals 423 width equals 634
Equals White House Chief of Staff John Kelly sent a memo around Wednesday to West Wing staff telling them their personal electronics were banned from work class equals blocks bordering share, greater than plus 5 in guide.d.equals i a 843 c9 e 15 68 cd 53 c src equals http colon slash slash i dot daily mail dot co dot uk slash i slash pics slash 2018 slash 01 slash 10 slash 23 slash 47 ff 2000575254255 image a 17 underscore 15 6 2 2058 dot jpg height equals 423 width equals 634
Personal cell phones of staffers will no longer be allowed in the Oval Office or other parts of the West Wing, starting on January 16. Class equals blocks bordering share, greater than violations of this policy by IP staff or security incidents that may indicate knowing, willful, or negligent conduct in violation of security policy and may therefore result in disciplinary action and, for other federal employees and visitors, may include being indefinitely prohibited from entering the White House complex, the memo said. Advertising in reinvented by Teeds the policy, which a senior administration official verified for ABC News, is intended to protect White House information technology infrastructure from compromise and sensitive or classified information from unauthorized access or dissemination. President Trump's aides had previously been told they shouldn't use their personal phones for official government business. Kelly told West Wing staffers to leave the contraband at home, in their cars or in their offices located outside the West Wing. Plus 5 in guide.d.equals i 2763923a8b023c59src equals http colon slash slash i dot dailymail.co.uk slash i slash pics slash 2018 slash 01 slash 10 slash 23 slash 47 ff to date 00005785256425 image a18 underscore 15156272310100.jpg height equals 357 width equals 634 alt equals 8 like Stephen Miller, seen typing on his phone before a meeting last February, will only be allowed to carry around the West Wing government-sanctioned equipment class equals blocks bordering share, greater than plus 5 in guide.d.equals IE18DC3EE1FAD3D4A4SRC equals http colon slash slash i.dailymail.co.uk slash I slash pics slash 2018 slash 01 slash 10 slash 23 slash 47 ff to so 00005785256425 image a19 underscore 15156272468 61.jpg height equals 423 width equals 634 alt equals Counselor to the President Kellyanne Conway, left, will have to use a phone issued through the White House Communications Agency if she wants to recreate this viral image from February class equals blocks bordering share, greater than plus 5 in guide.d.equals i9f98364210eb1src equals http colon slash slash i.dailymail.co.uk slash i slash pics slash 2018 slash 01 slash 10 slash 23 slash 47 ff to 00005785256425 image a20 underscore 15156272914453.jpg height equals 502 width equals 634 alt equals President Trump's social media guru Dan Scavino, right, will have to do all of his work on a government-issued phone, according to a new policy put out by Chief of Staff John Kelly, left, class equals blocks bordering share, greater than Dan Scavino talking social media impact for Trump campaign loaded, 0% progress,
0% 0:00 previous play skip live immute 0:00 current time 0:00/duration time 3:17 full screen me text video quality 576p 540p 360p 270p foreground white black red green blue yellow magenta cyan opaque semi opaque background white black red green blue yellow magenta cyan opaque semi transparent transparent window white black red green blue yellow magenta cyan opaque semi-transparent transparent font size 50% 75% 100% 125% 150% 175% 200% 300% 400% text edge style none raised depressed uniform drop shadow font family default monospace serif proportional serif monospace sans serif proportional sans serif casual script small caps defaults done minimize expand close the White House also has lockers available for staff. The devices will be outlawed from between the president's residence, which is in the main part, of the mansion, to West Executive Drive, the road on the other side of the West Wing office complex. That means lower-level staff working out of the Eisenhower Executive Office building, which is across West Executive Drive, won't be subject to this particular ban. The memo also notes that, for purposes of this policy, the West Wing does not include the James S. Brady Press Briefing Room, any White House press corps workspaces, or any outdoor common area, such as the Rose Garden or the North Lawn media positions. The timing of the ban comes on the heels of President Trump's White House having to deal with days of negative media coverage thanks to the publication of the new book, Fire and Fury, Inside the Trump White House. Author Michael Wolff said he got most of his juicy tidbits from sitting on a couch in the West Wing, but also from staffers leaking gossip to him as well. White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders, however, said that reporters shouldn't read too much into the timing, as the ban was long planned. Absolutely not. That's a ridiculous characterization, she said, when asked if the cell phone ban was a response to the book. This is about the security and the integrity of the technology systems here at the White House, Huckabee Sanders said. A former senior White House official backed up Huckabee Sanders' claim telling ABC that banning certain electronics in the West Wing has been discussed since the early days of the Trump administration. I know that there are other reasons like the leaking, but this does come out of a concern with national security issues, the former official told the network. The Chinese and Russians using personal cell phones and compromising them as listening devices, the source said.